Spencer McLaughlin of Locked On College Football joining Locked On Big 12. Avery Johnson has been predicted by the New York Post to win the Heisman. Not Quinn Ewers, not Shedeur Sanders, not the running back from Michigan. Edwards is his
Donovan
last
Edwards.
Name.
Donovan Edwards. Come on, Drake. He's on the cover of VA College Football 25.
And I always get him confused with Donovan Smith, who played college football for a really long time and still.
Though this is Locked On
football.
Big 12, so I guess you're given grace.
100%. Avery Johnson started a couple games last year, three, and now he is the Heisman pick for the New York Post. They're going with a crazy outlandish outlier, the sophomore from Kansas State. Your immediate reaction to a 19, 20-year-old winning the Heisman out of Kansas State?
If you were talking about winning the Big 12 Heisman, then
not a thing,
this is less not crazy. Okay, Big 12 Offensive Player of the Year. How about that?
We're going to have them.
If you want to make that prediction, that's well within reason. To say he's going to win the National Heisman Trophy, boy, Kansas State, first of all, Kansas State has to win the Big 12, make the playoff. Okay? That is
the era of the RG3 and Lamar Jackson is gone. I don't think we have that anymore. We can't do that anymore.
I mean, Jaden Daniels did win the Heisman last year.
Yeah, they didn't make the playoff either, did they?
Yeah.
Oh, shoot, they weren't that good.
They're also LSU. They are also LSU. And also, in defense of the argument that you were making that has some merit to it, just not quite as much as you were hoping for, hence the backtrack on your face and the literal movement back in your chair right there on camera, Bo Nix was going to win the Heisman until they lost the Pac-12 title game. Once they lost that, it went to Jaden Daniels. But Bo Nix was the betting favorite, and I think if he takes a 12-1 Oregon team into the college football playoff, yeah, he's winning the Heisman Trophy. So it definitely does help a great deal when your team has the sort of success that garners that level of attention, particularly at a program like Kansas State, who are going to play a really, really fun schedule this year. They've got the non-conference game with Arizona. They, of course, are going to play Kansas in a game where the winner could end up in the Big 12 championship game. There are a lot of really intriguing matchups on Kansas State's schedule this year. Are they going to be as high profile as Avery Johnson would need them to be to just have a really good year rather than a historic year to win the Heisman Trophy? My guess is no, that will not happen. And so for Avery Johnson to win the Heisman Trophy, Kansas State has to have no more than two losses. They have to win the Big 12 championship game. So, you know, 11-2 baseline. And then you have to get into the playoff with the automatic bid. And then he has to have a spectacular season. Now, the reason that this is not like such a crazy hot take that it's just to get shows like this to talk about it and generate buzz and whatnot is Avery Johnson is a dual threat quarterback. And last time I checked, dual threat quarterbacks are the most likely player in the last 10 years to win the Heisman Trophy. Talk about Jaden Daniels, talk about Caleb Williams, talk about Bryce Young, right? Then there's a Devontae Smith in there. Then there's a Joe Burrow. 2018 was Baker Mayfield, who didn't run a ton. You had Kyler Murray the year before. Then you had Lamar Jackson. How many of those guys are running quarterbacks? The numbers that you can put up, I think, lend very favorably to a guy getting on people's radar and staying there in the statistical sense. So that's why it's not crazy. This is probably a better prediction or something to monitor in 2025 because we haven't seen him start for an entire year. But that's how I react to the idea that he wins the Heisman this season. Unlikely. Less than 1% chance.
I like Avery Johnson a lot. And the sample size he gave us, including four rushing touchdowns in the game last year, was very good. I think he could be one of the best young stars in the Big 12, not just this season, but as you said, moving forward.
He's going to be an electrifying football player to watch. I think him with Dylan Edwards in the backfield coming over from Kansas State and help me remind me of the Wildcats starting running back going into this year. Okay, good job.
What was the question?
Who is Kansas State's starting running back? His name just went out of my head.
Edwards, the Alabama kid.
Dylan Edwards? The guy that got from Colorado?
Yes, Colorado, not the Alabama kid. The Alabama
Is he going to start? I thought they had a guy who was already in the room. I apologize to the Kansas State fans. This is a tangent I did not prepare for, but we're just kind of going off on anyway. But anyway, that backfield is probably going to be the most electrifying and perhaps potent rushing attack in the Big 12. I know a lot of people look at teams like
Hodge
Oklahoma
Brooks.
State.
Devin Neal, Ollie Gordon?
Ollie Gordon behind
DJ Donaldson?
Behind maybe the best offensive line in the Big 12. I think that has plenty of merit to it. I think Avery Johnson, though, brings a running element that Alan Bowman does not to the quarterback position. So I think that backfield could be dynamic and explosive. You can have a lot of other really, really good quarterback running back tandems going into the season in the Big 12, but certainly Avery Johnson with the guys they have there. I expect Kansas State and Chris Klieman to be running the football a lot.
Alongside DJ Giddens, who is good at football.
Thank you. Thank you.
Spencer, quickly before we go, Shedeur Sanders to Jalen Daniels, tell me like that. There's a pretty weak Cam Rising. Is Avery Johnson better right now than any of those?
Well, no, I mean, today, too, I mean, before he's, you know, started another game in college football, I'd say the answer is no. But I mean, being eighth or ninth in the quarterback rankings in your conference, in the best quarterback conference in the country in the Big 12, I don't think is anything to be ashamed of. I mean, when you have an early first round NFL draft pick and a two-time Power 5 conference champion in the last times that he started in Cam Rising, and you've got Noah Fifita, who was the Pac-12 offensive freshman of the year a season ago. Like, can I keep going, please? Because I will. Jalen Daniels is a freaking rockstar. Garrett Green at West Virginia. Like, just so many. I didn't even talk about Baron Morton at Texas Tech, another guy who could be a big riser going into this year. By the way, speaking of Avery Johnson, I just put this connection together in my head. This is going to be so sharp. You're going to compare it to a pinpoint needle, and then you're going to just, like, end the show because it's going to be really good. Play style and upper ceiling potential for Avery Johnson is Jalen Daniels at Kansas. I see a lot of similarities between those guys and the way they use their legs, but are also capable throwers and just great leaders of the offenses that they orchestrate, and a lot of the offense will run through them. So that's my sharp take to end the show.
I hope his bones, tendons, and ligaments are stronger. That's my only request with Avery Johnson.
That is a good request. That is a good and important request. Fact check here. You cannot win the Heisman if you can't stay healthy all season long.
That's good. I will make sure that I give it a good Google and see.
We should have ended with my Avery Johnson, Jalen Daniels game. It was
that
much
is Spencer
better.
McLaughlin at S McLaughlin CFB on Twitter. He hosts Locked On College Football. You can find it wherever you get your podcasts, as well as Locked On Big 12. Come back on Monday. By then, Florida State and Clemson will have joined the conference, so we'll break that down on Locked On. Thanks for making it your first listen every single day. Dose Grande. All right, we're out.